And we're back with another episode of Off the Ball with Allie Riley. This week, I interviewed a real live Viking. She shows off her super strength, her unique singing skills, and teaches me the two most important words in the Icelandic language. Let's check it out. This is Gunnhildur Yrsa Jónsdóttir.
Oh, that's so much better than
better. She said it wasn't better. Good, it was better. Please say it how it should be said.
Gunnhildur Yrsa Jónsdóttir.
Known as Gunny to everyone who loves her most. Yes. Gunny, thanks for being on the show today.
Thanks for having me.
I didn't know I was missing part of my soul until I met you. So we have hashtag we are one.
Yeah, we are one. Yeah. Hashtag everyone. Yeah. Yeah. It's weird that we haven't met until now.
What are your goals, hopes, or dreams for 2021?
Grow as a person, make myself a better human and the people around me, and try to make this world better one day at a time.
You were many people's favorite Royals player, and so many people wrote about their daughters and what impact you had on their daughters. So many people said that you were the last player on the field. Even they were trying to usher you to the locker room and you stayed out there. So I think huge testament to who you are as a person.
I remember when I was young, I met this Icelandic girl who was playing then in the league here.
Really?
And that moment still sticks to me to this day. And if I can impact only one girl, that's enough for me.
So it's good you mentioned kind of when you were younger, because yes, you were born in Iceland.
Yes.
But there was kind of formative years spent in Philadelphia where Eminem and Allen Iverson were your kind of, I don't know about role model,
and but role model, like just
icon, just yeah. Everything to you.
We lived in Philadelphia. I wanted to be the next Eminem. Yet the next Allen Iverson. But then I stepped on a basketball field and that
dream field.
Oh, see, a
that's
court.
Probably
see,
that's shows.
So I had to give up on that dream really quickly. So I decided rapping would be my way in.
Your email address was?
GunnyMathers@msn.com. I'm so sorry to my mother and my siblings who had to listen to me.
You're funny, Gunny. Runny Gunny, yeah. And just like the most fun girl, down for everything, up for a challenge. So I have three challenges for you.
Okay, yeah.
It's not rapping, unfortunately, okay. But this is kind of your chance to maybe then
transition.
Transition. Not that you need to leave your day job, but if you would have to, that maybe you could take Iceland to the next level at the Eurovision Song Contest.
This Off the Ball challenge is brought to you by Goal 5. The sports brand for her. Back to the show.
One, two, three, and.
See a little silhouette of a man. Lightning. Very frightening.
Galileo.
Figaro.
That 2009 was the first time Iceland qualified for the Euros. And how have you seen the development in Iceland with women's soccer?
Oh, it's been amazing. And even just the young girls that are coming up in the national team now are fantastic and so good and way better than I ever was or ever will be. So it's just wonderful to see that. And I think it just comes from the mentality that Iceland has.
So LA, Pepperdine, Malibu for what, three months?
A semester and one-third of a semester.
So what did you do in L.A.? Did you love it? Obviously not enough to stay, but
I loved it. I did all this. I went to Hawaii. I went to Las Vegas. I went to Santa Barbara, San Francisco. I went to all these concerts. But first and foremost, I was there to play soccer and get
course,
an education.
Of course, of course. Yeah, we
everyone.
Know that.
Yeah,
right,
yeah,
right,
yeah.
Who is your number one biggest inspiration?
My mom and grandma. And then right after my grandparents and my parents, it's Eminem.
So you're one of eight children.
Yes.
In your family. I've been lucky enough to meet half the gang now.
I actually had New Year's with the two of them, my younger sister and my younger brother. And I sat staring at a white wall because they were just on their phone like this the whole time. So.
When I think about Iceland, obviously Eurovision is one aspect of it. Yeah. We also have CrossFitters. Why do you think that is? Are you guys, what are you eating? What are you drinking? Is it the air?
Well, there's a couple theories. Our water, great. Our
great
fish,
water.
Great.
Wow.
No, and I think it's the mentality. We have a different kind of mentality. We're very proud and yeah, we're kind of crazy like that. And we believe we can do anything.
Gunny, she is our Nordic queen. And we also have become quite well known for our planking ability, as seen here. And we have attempted a new exercise, a new challenge.
Yes, a new maneuver.
So just to wrap us up here, I was wondering if you could teach me a couple important Icelandic phrases.
Okay. Jæja.
Jæja.
It could mean whatever. It could mean so many things.
Okay.
It could be like, well, so jæja. If you know that, you can just...
I have to say something else after? If
no,
someone
it's just
says something,
like,
I can just say
jæja. Jæja. That means like, let's go.
Jæja. Like,
yeah, and then you could be like, yeah, yeah. You know, you can work with that word so much.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Whew, that's like you're worried, you know? So you're good. Yeah, yeah. And you can literally.
So that's it. That's all you need to know. Okay, what about like bathroom?
Closet.
Oh, like water closet?
Closet?
Closet.
Closet? Closet, yeah.
Closet?
Closet.
Closet.
Yeah. Closet. Oh, that's good.
I like how you keep saying it as if I'm saying it wrong, but like all I hear is me saying the same thing that you're saying. Gunny, thanks so much for being on Off the Ball and putting up with me and my ridiculous challenges, but you did very, very well. And I'm excited to be your teammate and see what we can achieve this year together.
I cannot wait.